A memorial that sat on the side of a road for 11 years has now disappeared. It marked the spot where the passenger of a drunk driver was killed west of Winters. KCRA3's Mallory Hoff explains who's taking credit for snatching the monument and why Caltrans says it shouldn't have been there to begin with.
Gone too soon. Those are the words on a monument in remembrance of Tim Casson, the passenger of a drunk driver. He died on the side of Highway 128 in 2002. A memorial went up soon after, and that's where it sat until now.
The entire monument is missing.
Left in its place, a laminated handwritten note that states the memorial is illegal and dangerous and has been removed by a group that calls itself the Safe Motorcycle Riders Association. They're not in the phone book.
My brother got killed in an automobile accident. I'm not going to put something that's going to create another accident.
Caltrans officials say that's exactly what they're worried about. And when it comes to any roadside memorial,
doesn't matter if it's on state property or private property. If it is viewable from a state highway, it is not allowed. We don't need another tragedy.
This is where the memorial sat for 11 years. During that time, the family says they were never contacted by authorities to move it.
It's a rural area. It could be that it just went unnoticed.
But to the note crafter,
we don't want anybody stopping on the highway and be a vigilante repair person.
In this case, likely more than one person. It weighs about 300 pounds.
I wanted to do the best job I could to build something for family, friends, and everybody to come just remember him.
For the father who lost a son,
it basically brings it all back.
Looking down at the empty space is symbolic of the emptiness in the heart of a parent whose child is gone too soon.
It immediately struck both of us just the same as it did the day that we were told that he died.
In Yolo County, Mallory Hoff, KCRA 3 News.
Now, Caltrans does work with Mothers Against Drunk Drivers. Under certain circumstances, they put up don't drink and drive signs in areas where people have been killed. Caltrans determines locations that will not be distracting to drivers.